So good morning friends, today we will discuss about the positive crankcase ventilation. Okay, so before proceeding to the topic, let us see what is positive and what is negative pressure. So what is positive pressure? Any pressure which is in the compressed state. Okay, so if the air is in compressed state, then that pressure is called as a positive pressure, and if the air is in the vacuum state, okay, then that pressure is called as a negative pressure. Okay, so now the name implies that the positive crankcase ventilation, the positive means the air is in the compressed form. Okay, now the positive crankcase ventilation means in the crankcase, this is the crankcase of an engine, and due to the as the piston reciprocates in the cylinder, then what happened? Due to this reciprocating motion of the piston, what happened? There is a compressed air below the piston, as shown by this diagram. Okay, so when the piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center, then what happened? The air present inside this crankcase will be in the compressed state. That's why it is called as a positive crankcase ventilation. Okay. Now, why the positive crankcase ventilation is necessary to an engine, that we will discuss. So first of all, this is the cut section of any engine, any four stroke engine. In that four stroke engine, you will see that this is a cylinder, piston, this is a crank, this is a crankcase, okay, and this is a what we say a positive crankcase ventilation. Okay, this system, these pipelines, okay, these are all the pipelines of positive crankcase ventilation system. Okay, so what happened in the engine? When the engine is working at a normal speed, then what happened? When there is a power stroke, okay, lot of pressure is exerted at the top of the piston during the power stroke, due to which what happened? Some due to rising pressure in this clearance volume, then what happened? Some gases may be leaked out through this clearance between the cylinder and piston, okay, and some gas may also escape from the piston ring, compression rings, etc., and these gases will passes from this clearance of piston and cylinder and moves into this crankcase. Okay, so this process is called as a blow by or blow by gases. Okay, so all these gases, what happened when the engine runs? So there is a leakage from this clearance, and this from this clearance, these gases will leak and move to the crankcase. And in the crankcase, what happened? As these gases are in the burn stage, then what happened? This gas, the presence of gas and the presence of oil, it will dilute the lubricant oil. Okay, when these gases contains the some burned particles, some unburned particles. Okay, so what happened? Some carbon particles are also there in these gases. Then what happened when this gas comes in contact with this lubricant oil? What happened? This dilutes the lubricant oil and forming a sludge of carbon. And due this sludge of carbon is a thick wax type material. Okay, which is a what we say, the density is higher than the lubricant oil. Okay, this sludge is formed at the bottom of this crankcase. Okay, now what happened during the passage of time, when the engine runs at several lakhs kilometer, then what happened is the amount of the sludge formation will be higher. Okay, and due to this sludge formation, what happened? This sludge will choke the strainer of the lubricant system. And when this sludge chokes the strainer of the lubricant system, it prevents the oil to move from this sump to lubricate the various part of the engine. Okay, that means it restricts the free flow of the oil to the lubrication system due to formation of sludge. And if the sludge formation is too much, then what happened? At certain cases, what happened? Due to the clogging of the lubrication system, this engine will cease. Okay, so that is very undesirable condition. So this formation of sludge should be restricted and due to which this gases which is present in the crankcase should be escape out from the crankcase, and it from these gases will again recirculate into the combustion chamber, or in some cases it may be expel out in the atmosphere. Okay, so this is the primary reason why the positive crankcase ventilations are given into the engine. At the same time, what happens, some engines are also run underwater. Okay, some engines such as tanks engine, okay, which are designed to run underwater also. So in that case, what happened, this positive crankcase ventilations are given to that engines so that water should not enter into the crankcase, and this engine can easily run inside the water. Okay, now what happened when this engine is running at when engine is running at the normal speed, then what happened, the temperature of the engine gets increases. Okay, so when the temperature of the temperature of the engine hikes, then what happened, the oil inside the engine will also heaten up. Okay, now what happened, when the oil is heated, it will be converted into vapors. Okay, the oil vapors will be present in the crankcase, and at the same time, and due to the combustion of the charge here, these some charges will expel out in this clearance, by this clearance between the piston and cylinder. Okay, and some gases will be blow by inside the crankcase. Okay, now what happened, when the piston will move from TDC to BDC during the power stroke, then what happened, here there is a positive pressure exerted by the bottom of the piston. Okay, bottom of the piston exerted a positive pressure on these gases. So these gases contains the oil vapors as well as unburned fuel particles, burned fuel particles, and some hydrocarbons. All these impurities are present here. Okay, and all these impurities are pushed by piston in the downward direction when the piston moves from TDC to BDC. So these burned gases will move from this line. Okay, this is called as a positive crankcase line. Okay, so this line, all the impurities will be passes through this line, and it will goes to the oil separator. Here what happened, this oil separator is a this is a mesh type grill inside it. It is a mesh type structure where what happened, the all the charge will move here, and what happened, the oil will condense on the mesh here, and oil will condense and it will drop back into the oil sump. And this oil, after separating the oil, these gases will which is free from oil, now this burn gases will go to the it will diverted into the what we say in modern engine, it is diverted to the EGR valve. Okay, and in some old engines, okay, it is these gases will be expelled directly, exposed directly to the atmosphere. Okay, so these are the old engines where the gases are exposed directly to the atmosphere. And in modern engine, what happened, these burn gases will be diverted to the EGR valve, exhaust gas recirculation system. Okay, now as these gases are in burn stage, so these gases will not take part in combustion. So because when this is diverted to the EGR valve, then what happened, these gases will again transfer back to the combustion chamber, and it reduces the temperature of the combustion chamber. And when it reduces the combustion of the temperature chamber, it doesn't forming the nitrox oxide, which is very harmful for the atmosphere. Okay, now as this is, these are the burn gases, and when it is passed to the combustion chamber, it will not take part into combustion chamber, due to which what happened, the overall rise in temperature will be reduced. Okay, and when there is a reduce in the combustion temperature, what happened, the NOx formation will be reduced. Okay, so there are two advantages of the positive crankcase ventilation. One is the there is a the loss of oil due to the evaporation will be prohibited by this oil separator, and second, the due to this recirculation of the gases, the formation of NOx will be restricted because of this introduction of this burn gas into the combustion chamber. Okay, so this is how the positive crankcase ventilation system works, and these are all the benefits of the positive crankcase ventilation. Okay, so all the modern engines which is having the positive crankcase ventilation, having the separate oil separator and this fresh charge, that is clean crankcase gases, will be again recirculated back into the engine combustion into the engine. And in the old engine, what happened, these oils, all the gases which are expelled out are directly exposed to the atmosphere, so the old engines are more pollutant and the modern engines are less pollutant because these gases are further recirculated into the engine, inside the engine. Okay, so this is how the positive crankcase ventilation works. Okay. Thank you.